Hello everyone, I'm Natalie Kunzman, MD, and today I would like to introduce you to ivermectin and COVID-19. Now I want to make a disclaimer that we need to take the politics out of any of this conversation, and honestly, a large portion of the United States was willing to put hope and time and investment and belief in a brand new immunization strategy for the war against COVID. And that does not have very much of a track record whatsoever. So I would like us to embrace the topic of ivermectin at least as strongly as the hope and belief that new technology is going to help us in this battle. So what is ivermectin? Well, ivermectin came out on the market at least 40 years ago, and it is an anti-parasitic and an anti-helminth. Okay, so we have been using this medication for a very long time, very safely for certain parasites and certain worms, and that is in us humans as well as our furry friends and our pets. So ivermectin, when it is working against the parasite or helminth, we believe it's working by going at the membrane within their small muscular system and getting in that membrane and paralyzing that musculature. And then in that regard, we are paralyzing those worms or paralyzing those parasites, and they die and our immune system sheds them and we get rid of them. Again, this has been done very efficaciously for several different strains of these. And when I say efficaciously, I also mean safely. In walks the repurposing of ivermectin. And I need to tell you that there are many medications that came out through the FDA throughout the years for one particular purpose. And we discovered that it may have worked for another purpose. And in that regard, we are reworking existing medications for other conditions. Now, sometimes those other conditions are such that that medication will come through the FDA again to get another or a dual purpose out of that medication. But sometimes we are reworking those medications without that FDA approval, sometimes nearly daily in our practice. Now, the proposal for ivermectin for COVID-19 virus is similar to the proposal for some of the other viruses it has been researched against. And for instance, it has been used against some RNA viruses, HIV virus, dengue fever, and some of those viruses are responding well to ivermectin and some are responding not so well to ivermectin. So what I would like to simply say about its mechanism of action is that ivermectin will go close to the nucleus, and there is a transporter protein that any virus needs to attach to, and that transporter protein might get it through that membrane to the DNA so that the DNA will take up this virus and the virus will replicate and make more viruses and make more proteins and make more capsids while it is within our DNA. Now, this ivermectin has been shown at least in vitro. So in vitro is, let's say, in the lab. It is affecting that transporter protein such that the virus, the transporter protein, and the ivermectin will be such that the ivermectin shuts that transporter protein down and the virus cannot get within that membrane and get to the nucleus. So in that regard, it is proposed to markedly reducing the potential viral load. Now, a viral load is the amount of virus that's in the system. So if it can't get into our DNA, it cannot duplicate, and it cannot overwhelm our immune system. And if it cannot overwhelm our immune system can take those few copies and break it down and eliminate it. Okay, so that's how ivermectin is proposed at working against the COVID-19 virus. Now, again, I often say desperate times call for desperate measures. And just like we got an emergency acceptance through the FDA to use a brand new novel immunity, such as the messenger RNA, to fight this virus with very minimal track record, I cannot say that ivermectin should be criticized. It cannot be criticized. We have been repurposing medications many times and in the viral battle. Now, with ivermectin, there are in vitro studies that are being performed. There are in vivo, in other words, in people studies that are being evaluated as we speak. Some are outside of this country and some are inside of this country. Now, I will not get into any dosing strategies because in this new information regarding ivermectin, we are still trying to figure out what dosing strategy might be good to prevent, what dosing strategy might be okay in the early throes of the treatment, and what dosing strategies may be used either in the severe cases and even in the long haulers. So again, we are considering this medication for several categories of patients suffering with COVID-19. Again, I want to keep this neutral so that you all understand the information that is being disseminated about this medication and whether or not you should be considered a candidate for a trial of this medication is a very individualized decision between you and your provider. There are some patients that have come to me because all else is failing. There are some patients that come to me because they are reading this evolving information as it is coming out to the market. Now, I would like to say that there is a group of physicians that are trying to pioneer the use of this medication with the small studies that have been out that are promising in this country and that are very promising outside of this country, and they are the frontline doctors. And they so far are considering that so far there are at least 60 trials that have been used with over 21,000 patients. Now, 21,000 patients sounds like a lot, but you know, when you are dividing that up into different trials, it is a small amount of number per trial. But again, the evidence is building that there is benefit with ivermectin in the COVID-19 battle. Thus far, some of the conclusions, and again, these are not my quotes, and this is not novel research that I have found myself, but we think that approximately 85% improvement is happening in the pretreatment people as getting less amounts of COVID. There is about 74% improvement thus far in the early treatment protocols. There is about 43% improvement in the late treatment protocols. And we are just starting to consider this medication in the long hauling category. Again, these are the frontline doctors' statistics up until this point. And again, all of this research is evolving as we speak. Dosing strategy is quite individualized. It needs to be managed by you and your provider. There is very little side effect profile when these medications are used in their standard doses, like anything else. Again, budding information, more and more will be coming. Please make sure to, what I would say, keep an open mind with all of the evolving literature. I don't believe we should close any doors when it comes to a virus that not only has spread and created a pandemic, but is now potentially transmuting to a Delta variant. And any way possible that we can improve our immunity to recognize this virus, I think is a win. Again, this is not a discussion about whether or not you'd like to vaccinate to prevent the illness, but whether or not you would like to consider adding more items in your arsenal in the COVID battle. Again, I'm Natalie Kunzman, MD. Subscribe to my channel below. And until we meet again, be well.